Hello YouTube and welcome to this video. I'm going to be showcasing off the Stunt Race Creator DLC in here and showing a few tips to using it, because in the creation tool I've noticed that there's a few intricacies and weird things about it that make it a little bit difficult to make tracks. But on that note, if you actually understand those intricacies and little things to do, you can make some amazing tracks. So I've just made a little demonstration here to show you guys what I've actually and what I can make and what you can make. But this isn't even anything, guys. This is just a proof of concept to show you exactly what you can achieve with like 2 5-minute worth of work. I'm sure if you put hours of time into this and ideas and the placement on where you're gonna put it, it would look much better. So without further ado, let's get into it anyway, guys. So let's get to the actual race. I'm just gonna show you guys a quick test, really, to show what I've done. So with this, I've created a ramp here which goes onto a track, right? And this is pretty cool in itself, because you don't go into the tube at the start. You come around back here, and this is to show you that you can make tracks that circle back on themselves with like weird intersections like this. And as you can see there, I mean, that looks pretty cool to me. It's not the most complex thing, but it's just a proof of concept to show you the kind of things that you might be able to use these track pieces for. But let's get further on into the tunnel anyway. And I've got the tunnel set up in a weird kind of corkscrew up here, and a helix, should I say. And this is pretty cool as well. The thing about the tunnels is it's really hard to create angles like this if you don't know what you're doing. I'll show you later on in the video what I mean by that. It's really, really odd. I don't know why they've created it like this, but once you actually do know how to manipulate them, it becomes really easy to create tracks like this at all sorts of angles. And the two pieces especially are really, really good for that. And obviously I fucked up. Oh my days. Okay. I knew that was there. But, you know, I'm the creator of this map, but I still fuck up. It's just gotta happen. And coming up to here, this is another cool thing. So this right here that we're on is a building block. And this is actually really, really important. And I'll show you what I mean by that later on. This is probably one of the most important pieces in the entire thing. There's a reason they put that in. I'll show you why later on. But anyway, let's get back up to the first lap anyway. And so there's the entire thing. Now, nothing too complex, nothing too long. Just a proof of concept. Takes like a minute to get around if you did it fast. You know, that's pretty easy. Let's get back into the editor anyway. Alright. So in this, I'm gonna show you how to make a little track like this. Nothing too complex. Again, I'm just gonna show you guys the basics, the editing tools, right? How to manipulate the track and how to make things like this in the basic form, and then you guys can go crazy and make all the loops and crazy shit. But let's get into a fresh track anyway. Alright guys, so getting into the creator menu and its start, this is what you're gonna come up to when you join it. And to get into the creator menu, just in case anybody doesn't know, you go on and get it through the online menu. If you hit escape or pause on your controller or keyboard, you'll pull that up and you'll be able to pull the creator menu up through the online tab. And once you do, you'll get to this section, and this is asking you basically what you want to do. So as you can see, you have a few options available to you. You can create a deathmatch, race, capture, blah blah blah. You guys can see that anyway. But once you create one of these, you'll get a bunch of subcategories up. So when you create a race, you'll get a tutorial creator, stunt race creator, land race creator. Sorry, that's not a tutorial, because that's actually the tutorial to it. The C-Race, blah blah blah, and so on and so forth. So we are gonna focus on stunt races, because that's obviously what just came out and what everyone's interested in. So when you load in, you're going to come to this menu for a start, and it's going to load you in somewhere, and this is a pretty simple menu at the moment. So what we got here is we got our location, and you can obviously see the tooltips at the bottom right tell me what buttons do what. So you can zoom in and out, which gives you better precision. You can hold Y to zoom in and out faster. As you can see, the speed is very different. And you can switch cameras, which allows you to go on the ground and test things out as well. And once you're in the ground, you've got to press the down button, and you can pull this up, and you can literally place things. Like, for example, you can place a trigger, you can place checkpoints, etc. It's a little weirder how this works compared to the camera, but you get the idea. You can fine-tune things, right? That's really simple. So let's go back into the normal creator, which you just hold. Sorry, not hold, but you just press back again to get back into here. And once we're here, the first thing we're going to have to do is we're going to have to place a trigger. This is the most important part of the entire thing. You can really mess up if you don't know what you're doing with the trigger. So what this trigger is it's that little thing that you see when you're in free mode, where you go to start, say, a stunt race or something, that the actual triggers that you can start without entering a menu. And this is going to be relatively in the same location to where the start of your race is going to be. And I'll show you what I mean by that. So for example, we're going to place our trigger here. So anybody that wanted to come and start this race would have to come to this location, and they would have to come to this circle here. Or they'd obviously have to join your lobby, but that's a different story. Anyway, the first checkpoint, you're going to create this right here. This is where everybody starts. As you can see, this is the starting grid. There's the trigger right there, and I'll show you, look, it can't be too far away. So if you're going to place a race and you wanted to place the trigger there, but you wanted your starting track here, you've got to place the trigger close to where your starting grid is actually going to be. So let's go back over to our trigger real quick, and I'm going to show you. So what about if you wanted to create a trace high up? Because as I showed you my race, it starts up on the track high up, right? Well, it only seems that the axis is to the left and right, which is the X and Y axis, the ones that are affected by this. So there does seem to be an effect on the other axis, the Z axis, but let me just show you what I mean by this. So we'll go to props, we'll go to the right one, which is the stunt race racetrack. This is, you guys should be used to this. This is the ones that they're pretty fucking huge, as you can see. So we're gonna place this next to our trigger. We're just gonna place it here, and then we're gonna go back. And we're going to go to our checkpoints, which is the starting grid. So as you can see, it's fine starting up here, but obviously, like, too far away, and you can't even place it anymore. So what about above? How does that work? Well, it's nice, because the Z-axis does seem to have a little bit of a difference. As you can see, you can place it above. This glitch is, by the way, an interesting glitch. I'm not sure what this is about. But as you can see, it's not actually aligned, right, to the stunt track. Like, the cars are not at the start lines. You just have to click this twice and it realigns it. I'm not sure what that's about, but that's how you fix that anyway. And another thing about this, the starting grid is changeable, so it depends on how many people you have in the starting grid. You can change that here, so you can have up to 30 players, as you can see. And you can change the grid size, but this is restricted when you've got it on the stunt grid layout for the start of these tracks. But we're just gonna have it on 8 people for a start. Just make it nice and simple, the default. All right. So now that we got the start of the grid, we can start working on the track from here on after. I just wanted to show you guys how you actually can make it on a racetrack above with a starting checkpoint, because this is the most focal point. This is where people mess up the most, is they create a trigger that's far away or in a place that's not going to be viable to where the start of the race actually is. And they create all that race and that track, and then they try and place the original checkpoint at the start and they mess this up. But anyway, let's get back into the props now. So the prop section is where you've got everything from stunt race stuff to just normal buses, you know, just a, wait, is this a bus? It's like a destroyed bus. All right, so you've got everything, but we're gonna focus on the stunt stuff right now. So I'm gonna start off with a racetrack. So as you see, you've got different grid sizes. You've got a standard grid like this. You got a grid like this, but this has got an alternate start, as you can see at the front. And then you got a 30-man grid, and then you got a 30-man grid that's alternate. And then you have these straight pieces, and as you can see, when you're trying to place these, it's just not going to work, right? It's just not going to work. So you need to enable this option, which is prop snapping. And as you can see, that snaps the props together in a really, really nice way. And when you've snapped a prop together as well, you can also alternate the piece, and obviously it's going to mess up there. You can alternate the piece to some degree at least, and it will still try to snap in as best as it can. And once you've actually placed a piece, it will automatically snap to the next piece. To show you what I mean by that, we place it, and as you can see, it snaps to the next piece. And it will allow you to keep going on and so forth. So we'll start off like that. That's just how to basically start off the snapping. So let's say we wanted to go back into Fort Zancudo, and we want to go down. And as you can notice, there isn't much options for ramps in this game. Like, we have stuff like this, and that works. But what about if you wanted to create a very, very custom sized ramp? You know, like, what about if you wanted it at a specific slope? And this is where things get interesting, because you can do this with a lot of different prop types. And I'll show you a real neat trick here, which is what you want to do is go into the advanced options, go into snapping options, and enable triggered snapping. And then once you've got that, you'll get a prompt at the bottom left that says snap hold, as you can see at the bottom, at the bottom right. And as you can see on my screen, it's X for the Xbox controller. And when I press that, As you can see, it's snapped into place. And if you hold X, as you can see, you can actually move around, which gives you a really good ability to see your pieces precisely and what's happening to them and what you're doing and what you're manipulating. And so basically, here's another cool feature about this, is if you hit the rotate button while you're in this, you can, well, not with these pieces, you have to use these pieces. You can't use the raised pieces when you're creating this, but if you snap a piece like this in, for example, and you hold the rotate button, you can actually create an elevation and change the pitch. So you could create some very, very, very custom, like, look at this. That's just crazy. That is actually just crazy. So let's use the long track, for example. We'll make a very, very, very strange ramp. And we just got to keep snapping it back in place. And as you can see, we can create a ramp that's not even in any of the default ramps. And that makes its own kind of unique fact about it. Like, you know, you're not just constricted to the pieces in the sets as what you can do. Like, we can make a flat piece here with a short road for like a leveling off point. Just a little bit. And as I'll show you, you can hold the... and now it's going to be awkward, of course. Alright, I've got to hold the snap. 1 second. Oh my days. Alright. This is the one thing. There's a lot of little issues like this in the editor, but you'll get used to this as time goes on. I'm just trying to show you the basics. And it's not snapping for some reason. Of course it's going to do this. We just got to... Alright, if this actually happens, I know how to fix this. So, you can elevate and decrease the elevation of pieces by, for me, holding in the analog sticks. So as you can see like this, we pull the piece up relatively close to the other piece, and then we hold X. Boom, it fixes it. And then we can look around now. Now we can look around. And then you can get a good idea of how level your piece is. Say I want to make this a road that's actually pretty level. I can just elevate that, change it, look at the background compared. And I can make very, very precise adjustments, and then we can create a ramp that goes all the way down. But this is where things get interested again. So now we've made a little bit of customness to the track, right? We've edited things beyond what the normal pieces allow you to edit by changing the pitch. But what about if we say you want to create a crazy tunnel? So we'll go to the tunnel pieces. And the most suggestive thing I would say is after you've done a ramp downwards is probably to create a tunnel piece that is a corner like this. Because it allows you to just go straight into the corner and you can retain all your speed. I'll show you what I mean by that. It's interesting. But here's another thing that happens here. So here's another issue. And this is what this video is about, really. Just to show all the little interesting intricacies and things. So as you can clearly see, it's only going to the half level. And that's not snapped properly, is it? And you probably want that to be at the base. So that the base of the tube is touching the end of the road. God, this is getting dirty. Anyway. What you got to do for this is keep holding X after you've snapped. So we're still holding X, so it's snapping to the object. And then you go to Advanced Options, and then you override the position and hit the override here. And once you've hit that, you can let go of X. And that's just crazy. But once you actually adjust a value, that'll stop. That doesn't normally happen as well. There's just some... They'll fix all this stuff. Anyway, we can raise the tube so that the tip's there. But as you can clearly see, now it's having other issues, so we just need to adjust it like this using these details and numbers. And we can get it perfectly fitting. There you go. Perfect. Anyway, going back into it. Let's say we wanted to continue snapping these tubes together. You literally just have to re-enable prop snapping as the auto align or the override disables it. And then it will snap back together really nicely like that, as you can see. So you can carry the tunnel on and we can create a... Wrong option. We can go back to the tunnels and we can create a really long extension after this. As you can see, so it gets really high up after a large speed boost. So what about if you wanted to go back to a flat surface? So if we want to, for example... make this go back to being flat. And this is a little trick that I've had to figure out. So we go back to the corner piece. Let's find one. Where are they at? Aha, there's one. Alright. So, here is a good way. What you gotta do, you find a corner piece. So, any corner piece will work. And then, you can either find ones that make it look like it's... Some of them will actually snap it back, depending on the shape, really, really well. Like, this one actually looks like it's pretty flat, to be honest. Like, look at that. It's only at a very small angle, but just to show you, it's at a shallow angle, to be honest. It's not completely flat. It looks like it's going down just slightly. So what you got to do is you go to the stunt set pieces, I think it is. No. It's the stunt special. So you can use these, or you can go to the stunt building blocks and you can use these. And so these are interesting pieces because, and let's turn prop snapping off for a second. These are always flat like this. They're at a straight flat angle, and we need to enable prop stacking right here. And this is another option. And what this allows you to do is put props on top of each other. But on top of that, it allows us to align them inside each other like this. So if we do this, and then let's say we put this building block here. That building block is now flat. So let's go back to the tubes, and anything we snap to the side of this tube, to the side of this building block, sorry, will literally be flat. So it's gonna be awkward, of course. Let's do this again. And yeah, there we go. We've leveled it back out, as you can see. So what we can do here is we don't want it at the half point once again. The snapping is being a little awkward. We don't want it at the snapping. We don't want it at the half point again. So we need to go into the z-axis even, and we need to raise that up, which is gonna make it level, which you should be able to just transition in. As you can see, you'll literally just ramp over that very finely. But the key part is it's now flat, so we can continue on using the default position. Oh, I deleted my piece. I accidentally hit the reset button on it. Alright, so if we connect a long piece to this now, and we go back into a corner, so we just need to go find a corner. And then we go down into a... Oh, wow, that one has a hole in it. That's interesting. And this happens sometimes. You'll get used to all these little things with the editor, the camera view weirdness. It's not that bad, to be honest. You just keep snapping anyway. And then you can go back to a normal tube, and you can just use the editor as it's normally intended, and you can get back to a flat surface. So these tricks you can use to make some really interesting tracks, for example, because you could go to the taunter piece, you could make loops like this, so that you actually you can make some crazy stuff like this, and you could you get the idea, right? You could just go crazy with this, and you just, holy crap, I can't even imagine the kind of things you could do around buildings with this. But after that, We can pretty much make this a circuit, just to show you that you can make some crazy tracks and bring it all the way back around. So we'll go back down, and I gotta do the trick again. This is a very useful trick that you will need to learn. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna snap this down so that we kind of come back into the same elevation as our track, because we want to make it a circuit so that you can actually make a lap on this. So that looks like a little bit too steep of a curve. So we have to try and get a lighter corner. Is there a, yeah, like that. No, maybe not. You know what, interesting idea. You can make like a gap like this and put a ramp in it so that you hit it and then you just kind of go up. We're not going to do that. We're going to do something else. I just need to find a corner piece that will work well with this. Okay, I'll work with this. I don't even know if that's the original one, but I'll work with it. So we're just going to use that old trick again. We're going to go back to the building blocks, but we're going to get a larger one this time. Something like this. And then we're going to enable disable snapping and enable prop stacking again. You need to get used to all of these options. That's why I'm here, to show you them and how to use them. And what we're going to do, we're going to have it end here. And then we're going to create another area so that we can go from the road here and we can go back to the normal circuit. So we go back to Enable prop snap. Actually, we're going to disable prop snapping. I'm going to use a shot arrow to make this a little more precise. Just for a second. And then I'll re-enable it, as you'll see. And we will find a corner. I need a... something a little bit... yeah, more like this. This looks like it'll do the job. And now snapping to the wrong thing. There we go. And look, there we go. We've created our track, falling toe. We made a full circuit back. And using all the tricks, we've actually made a pretty interesting track. But there's still going to be some more issues that I'm going to go through once you've created the track, because we'll just test it and I'll show you what I mean. So we need to create, just to show you the test, I need to create a starting checkpoint. The car's going to start to struggle quite a little bit to get up this ramp. But that's all good. That's all good. Now, for a race perspective, though, I don't think this would obviously be the most fun. I mean, everyone just driving up real slow. And that's where the boosts are going to come into play. But I don't want to go over the top with the boosts, because then you would obviously just ramp over this section here, and you would completely lose the ability to actually go into here. So I'm going to show you the further things I'm going to use to fix this. In this next section of the video, I am going to be showing off how exactly to make this race a little bit more fun than it already is. So just to enhance the, you know, the playability of it. So first off, we got to go to the stunt special category. And we will go to the speed race boost track. And what this is, it's going to boost up. So I'll just showcase it. It will snap to the track and it will boost players up the ramp. So obviously when you're coming up here, you're going to get a huge massive speed bump. What about when we get to the top here, when we get to this next section? We're going to add more speed boosts. But as you know, when you get to this section, you're going to come down a ramp. And when you come down that ramp, you're going to come into a tunnel, and it's very, very precise. So obviously you need to not ramp over that, because you would just go flying into the ocean. So what you want to do is you want to pull up the stop brakes, and there's various different ones for different sizes, and you just pull the ones you want up and you put them down. We'll make this look a little bit neater. We'll delete this and we'll just do it like this. Alright, so whenever people come up to that, they'll stop, they'll be able to come here, and they'll be able to do that nicely. You could add some more there, but I'm not going to for the purpose of this. So what about putting things in tunnels? Because as you can see, it's a little bit weird. You'd like put objects on the outside of tunnels, but you can, unlike normal buildings, when you try to zoom through buildings or any other objects, you get stuck on it even there, right? You can't zoom past. But in a tunnel, you can go right through it. It's a nice feature they added. So you can come in here and you can add all your speed boosts that you want where you want them, and this can get a little bit awkward, but it works for the most part. Like, you might have to keep coming back outside your tunnel and going back in. And you can just keep holding Y. And this works fine anyway. This works fine. You can create anything you need to. So I'm going to showcase off this race one more time after this, by the way, to show all the little things that I've added and how they've enhanced the race. So these are also just important things you need to know, because in a lot of the races and ramps, you're going to be going up incredibly slow, and depending on the class of car you've got, you won't even be able to make the ramp. So it's very important to be able to add these speed boosts to tunnels and other things and know how to use them. But we've added enough there. We're just going to go over to this next section where you rise up here, and we'll add some. And here's another cool thing. So you can kind of make people go up a route here if you wanted. So say I wanted people to, and I'll show you, say you're in this tunnel. I can't actually go in. Well, let's just say you're in the tunnel, that people could be driving up any part of this tunnel, right, to get up. But obviously, if you had these speed boosts up specific sections, you can kind of enhance people going up these specific sections, and then people will kind of follow this path for you. It can, so if you have objects and stuff. So just to show, let me just finish this off first. And holy crap, what is happening here? That's some crazy stuff. Alright. So let's say you had some obstacles, sorry, in this race, and you could plant some obstacles that are in the tunnel on this section, like on the left half, so anybody coming up this part would crash into them. And you could create these to create a pathway so people know where to actually head. And you can even create them on the way going down so that you can make the wall riding more insane. Like, holy crap, you would be going so fast in this. You'll see, you'll see. And once you actually get to this point, because we're going to be going so fast when we go down this, you're going to need some more brakes. Because as I said before, if you come to this part, you are just going to fly out real fast. So we'll add brakes all to this section. And with the prop stacking on, it will just nicely snap inside for you. And you put it in all sorts of positions. But if you did want to put them on the roof as well, just in case people theoretically did, you can place it, say, like, we go to here. And then we override the position. And we lower down the y-axis. And then you got to alter the rotation. And you just turn it around like that. And then, once you're done, just hit A to place it. And you got one on your roof. You can obviously fine-tune it more so that it looks nice and aesthetic, so it's perfectly fitting, but that's just the idea anyway. And we'll just place some more just here, just so people don't ramp over. And there you go. So, at this point, I'm just going to add one last checkpoint to the race. I'm going to put it here just in case somebody does manage to fly out the side of the tube. Well, I guess they're not going to catch this. They're going to go way too high because those brakes are all over sections that are safe. So we'll test the race out now just to show you what it's like. Just to show you the enhanced track, and you'll get a comparison compared to the old track and how this edits it and makes it a little bit more interesting. So we'll just go around this nicely, showcasing off those waypoints as well, the differences. It already looks like a much more beautiful track, honestly. You can just see all the speed boosts. It just looks more aesthetic. And it's all about the aesthetics. Beautiful, beautiful aesthetics. And look at that. You see, this is why it is important for these brakes. Because can you imagine how much I would have just over-ramped that? And we go down. So, kind of did a burnout there. Not a burnout, I mean a spin out. And that kind of ruined all my momentum, but we'll carry on. I just want to show that it's a complete wrap, not doing the lap. Not doing the best in racing at the moment, though. Like, holy crap. Alright, and as you can see, I just caught the checkpoint again, and that's why it's important to have the circular checkpoints. Now that I come out of here, I hit the brakes, get my checkpoint, and we've made a lap. There we go, beautiful. Alright, so there you go, there is how you can enhance track, how to make a little bit of the custom, you know, intricacies to the tracks and how to edit things and edit the pitch and snap things together. I hope you have enjoyed the video. I have really enjoyed making it. And if you did like the video and you have learned something, please leave a like and a subscribe.